4 quick and easy steps to start selling on Amazon FBA right away. Because if you're selling on Amazon, then people like me will buy glasses like this from people like you. And so before you waste any time or make any catastrophic mistakes trying to start selling on Amazon, watch this video, use these strategies, and start your Amazon FBA empire. So I've been an Amazon seller for a few years now. We've made millions and millions of dollars selling on Amazon FBA. These are the same strategies I use myself. These are the same strategies that thousands and thousands of my students in my private student group use. So they're tried and true and tested, and they straight up work. But make sure you do stick around for the entire video, because we're gonna be revealing the number one mistake that most beginners make. And if you make this mistake, it's catastrophic and you could lose everything before you even begin. So make sure you watch the full video so that you don't make this common mistake most beginners do. And if you're new to the channel and you like making money, then tap on that little subscribe button right there. If you don't like money, you don't have to press it. But if you do, this is the strongest family anywhere on YouTube that teaches you the best money making strategies. Let's get into it. Step number one, guys, is you have to understand the process. You have to understand how all of this works. And literally the first step is signing up for what's called Seller Central. Seller Central is basically the overarching website that you use to actually sign in to your Seller Central account, right? This is where you actually become an Amazon seller. Access to Seller Central allows you to actually create product listings like we see every day on Amazon. Whenever you go to buy an Amazon product, that is essentially a product listing. Having access to Amazon Seller Central allows you to create your own product listings, list product to sell on Amazon, access the Amazon PPC systems, and so much more. It has everything that you need to start creating your Amazon empire from scratch. And people always wonder at first, you know, how does this whole Amazon FBA thing work? What exactly is it? Well, FBA stands for Fulfillment by Amazon. We've made millions of dollars selling products on Amazon, and I've never felt or touched any of my products myself. And the reason that that's possible is because Amazon fulfills it. Again, Fulfillment by Amazon, FBA. And so what you can do is you can actually order products from your manufacturer in China or in the USA or wherever you actually order your products from, and you can actually ship it directly from your manufacturer straight to an Amazon fulfillment warehouse where they handle all of the fulfillment for you. They do all of the hard work like picking and packing and actually putting products into the boxes, you know, taping it up, shipping it out, accepting payment, and they handle all of that stuff for you. And because they do, they take a cut and you take the profit in between what it costs you to actually buy the goods and what you actually can sell the goods for. And it's not an uncommon thing at all to buy goods, you know, based out of China or in the USA for a dollar or two and being able to sell those for $15 or even $20. And so there's a lot of profit in between. Amazon, of course, takes a cut, which we're gonna talk about a little bit later, but it's a very profitable business model if you know how to do it, which is what we're gonna talk about in this video. Step number two is you wanna find products that have a high demand and a low supply on Amazon. A lot of people don't realize this, but there's literally millions and millions and millions of different products that are sold on Amazon every single day. And because there's so many different products, really what you're gonna do is like with any business where you find something that has more demand than it has supply, and you come in with a higher quality product and you're able to outcompete anybody who's currently in that niche. And a good place to start when you're just starting out on Amazon. Again, this is a beginner's video where we're gonna talk about the things that have changed recently, because Amazon's changed so much recently. You need to understand kind of how the landscape has changed and what you need to do to be ahead. But the good place to start when you're first starting out to understand what types of products sell, you know, hundreds or thousands of times every single month on Amazon is simply to look at the Amazon bestsellers list, right? Because how Amazon ranks all of their millions and tens of millions of different products is using a system called BSR, which stands for best seller rank, right? Amazon has to have some systematic algorithmic way to actually sort through tens of millions of products. Obviously there's not, you know, a person sitting there actually doing it by hand. And so how they do it is with a best seller ranking system. And because they have the BSR system, you can actually see in any department, which you can see right here, any department, it actually shows you the best sellers in that particular department, toys and games, electronics, cameras, cameras and photo and things like that. One of the best categories to actually sell in to make money, and one of the categories that we've probably sold the most in during our Amazon careers, it has actually been kitchen and dining. We've made millions of dollars selling in the kitchen and dining space because there's almost infinite variability of what somebody could actually find useful for kitchen or dining, right? We can see a bunch of stuff here like water filters, things like that. But the problem is these particular products have, you know, 32,000 reviews. So we probably wouldn't want to actually come in and try to compete with that. But you can see that some products have 117 reviews. Some products have, you know, significantly less. And we can look through like literally all of these, right? This is 50. We can go to the next page. We can go to the next page and look at all of these different types of products, like super random stuff. 10-ounce Journey Kids Cup with straw, right? There's like a rainbow colored cup. And what is this? Powerlix milk frother, handheld battery operated electric foam maker for coffee, right? It's a milk frother. You know, so I love it. The point is there's basically infinite variability. I literally just bought this exact water filter like a couple of days ago, which is hilarious, right? Because people need this type of stuff, which is why it's selling so many hundreds of dollars a day, so many millions of dollars a day across all products, and why even if you just have a single product, you can earn a full-time income if you understand, you know, all of the things that we're gonna discuss in this video. And let me show you another example of an actual product that we've personally sold. So if we come in here and change this to all departments, what we can do is type in scratch off map. So scratch off maps a couple of years ago were just unbelievably popular. Like some of the people were making $100,000 a month during, you know, Q4 and things like that. And so we kind of noticed that, and that there was really only a couple of actual sellers in this niche. And we started to sell our own variant of the scratch off map. And we've sold tens and tens and tens of thousands, maybe even hundreds of thousands of these scratch off maps since we decided to actually come in to the space. At one point we were selling 1,000 maps a day. Or more. A good rule of thumb is if a product on average has less than 100 reviews, you can compete with that as a brand new seller. The hard part is when you're coming in as a brand new seller and every single person on page one, you know, like let's say that this one had 1,000 reviews, 10,000 reviews, 9,000 reviews, it's very difficult to actually unseat the incumbent in that situation. Because think about it like as a buyer. If you come in as a buyer and you type in scratch off map and there's one map that has 1,000 five-star reviews and one map that has zero or one or five, which one are you gonna choose, right? That's why reviews is such an important part of actually deciding what type of product to sell as a beginner. The next step you wanna take once you find an interesting looking product, or you find something that you think looks cool on the best sellers list, or just, you know, you think about a product in your daily life, I always am thinking about the next product that I could potentially sell on Amazon, just living my daily life. We've found products like acrylic sign holders, for example. I was just sitting at a Mexican restaurant and I saw these acrylic menu holders, and I just picked it up and I was like, I wonder if this is a product that people sell on Amazon. And it turned out people were making hundreds of thousands of dollars selling literally like little acrylic plastic sign menu holders where you just slip in like a paper menu. And they were selling them in packs of 30, and they're making hundreds of thousands of dollars a year selling acrylic sign holders. Because think about it, how many restaurants are there in the USA that have menus and need little sign holders to actually hold those menus up? And so I was literally just living my life thinking about potential products to sell on Amazon, and then I would run home and actually do research about whether or not that was actually a product that was selling well on Amazon. And so one of the next things you wanna do is check the actual keywords, because the thing is, a product might look good on the outside, but maybe it doesn't have enough people searching for that particular product, or it doesn't have enough ways that somebody could call a product. Like for example, one of the products that became popular about a year ago was called an angleized ruler, right? And it was an angleized ruler, and you know, like three people were making a bunch of money selling it. But the problem is there's only one way to actually write angleized ruler. Like nobody is calling that anything else. But to give you another example, a humidor is called a humidor, but a lot of people refer to it as a cigar holder. You know, some people are typing in gift for grandpa and then buying a humidor, right? So there's a lot of different ways that different people could call the same product. And the more keywords that people are searching that could eventually lead to a sale of your product, the better. And so you have to do your keyword research as well. And so that's gonna be the next step. And so the keyword research tool that we use use is called Zon Keywords. So if we take the same example and just type in Scratch Map here, Zon Keywords is gonna calculate all the data for us. So we can see that Scratch Map was searched 9,824 times in the last month. We can see that the popularity really spikes as far as the trend of how often people search it, just right around December of each year, which is why when we were selling it, again, we were selling over 1,000 a day at, you know, $15 profit each or something crazy like that, but it was during December because it makes a perfect gift for people who like to travel or need something for their house or something like that. And so that's why there's such a massive trend line here, which is important to know if you're actually getting into, you know, the scratch off map niche, because maybe you only want to order once a year and sell them during December. Another cool part of Zon Keywords that what they allow you to do is, you know, you can see other words that are similar, right? Like cute couple gifts. A lot of people are searching cute couple gifts and buying scratch off maps. Scratch map, maps, movie scratch off poster, travel map with pins, world, world scratch off map, right? And then we can see literally the estimated monthly search volume on Amazon when people are typing in these words. World map poster, scratch map, office decor for women desk, cool posters, you know, lots of different interesting things that actually lead to sales of this product. Because the thing is, people are typing in millions of different search words every single day, and it's impossible to predict that. So unless you have the real data from Amazon, you're kind of just going blind, which is why I use Zon Keywords. If searches have more than a couple thousand searches every single month, and, you know, overall have less than 100 reviews, you can feel better about the product. And so once you've actually identified a product, looked at the overall landscape of the product, how many reviews on average most of the sellers have on page one, what the keyword volume looks like, if there's multiple ways to actually type in what your product is that could lead to a sale, right? Not like the angleized rulers. Then step number three would be finding a supplier to actually make you this product in bulk. And the way that we do that is actually using a website called Alibaba. So again, if we use the same example and type in scratch off map, into products, we're gonna see a ton of different stuff. But another little tip that I like to use and that I teach my students is, a lot of times the same manufacturer will have multiple product listings. And so to save yourself time, instead of searching by products, you can actually search by suppliers, right? I don't recommend searching by wholesalers because that's just another intermediary who's taking a cut, which means that you don't get as good of a deal. So if you search actually by suppliers, what you're gonna see is only suppliers that actually make scratch off maps. And so you're not gonna essentially be contacting, you know, the same supplier multiple times if they have multiple product listings up. And so what you can see is these guys have been in business for 3 years. I like to look for people who've been in business for a number of years, who have a high number of high transaction volume, right? 110,000, good response rates, total revenue is between 2.5 and 5 million. You can see their last transactions in the last 6 months. And so you wanna look for people who have, you know, obviously a higher revenue, somebody who responds quickly, somebody who's been in business for 5 years, you know, or longer is generally pretty good. These guys have been in business for 13 years, you know, but they haven't done much business recently. So you wanna look for people who've done a lot of business recently, who have a high response rate, so you can actually open up those communication lines. And then you wanna actually look for somebody who has pictures, obviously, that look similar to what you actually want to get. And another cool thing that you can see is if we switch back to the product view right here, you can actually see that, you know, they're charging between $2 and $6.98 per piece, $1.30 to $2.20 per piece. I know for sure what we were paying for ours, right? We were paying right around $2 for a very premium version of this per unit. And then if we go back to Amazon, we can see that a lot of people are selling these for, you know, $22, $25, $29. And so if we're buying it for $2, and that's a landed cost, right? So our entire cost to get it made, created, packaged, shipped, and then landed in an Amazon fulfillment center was $2 per unit. And then if we're selling it for $29.99, right, that's a significant profit. That's how you actually get products that are really going to make you a full-time income. If you can find things for, you know, $2 and sell them for $30, if you can find them for $1, sell them for $15, something like that, right? Because you have to factor in the cost of the goods themselves, the cost of shipping, and you have to factor factor in, you know, Amazon's fees for actually doing most of the heavy lifting for you, PPC, and things like that. I generally like to see at least, at the very minimum, a 5x differential. So, you know, if you're buying it, landed cost is $3 per unit, selling it for 15. That generally gives you a nice amount of leeway to actually have enough profit margins to play with, so that you have a healthy enough amount of profit to invest in things like marketing, and, you know, reinvesting back into more products, expanding your product catalog. And that's really how you make a seven-figure business or beyond on Amazon. And so once you find a manufacturer that you're having a good time with, right, who's responding quickly, who's giving you a quote that gives you a lot of leeway to be able to sell your product actually, you know, for a 5x or more differential from your landed cost, what you want to do is actually give them a down payment, right? And generally how this works, when I was first starting, it took me forever to actually find what the kind of normal situation was, but generally how it works, no matter what your supplier tries to say, is you give them a 30% down payment, right, for them to get started. They complete all of the work. Then once it's actually done, all of your products have been made, you have a third party inspection service come in, look at all of the products, make sure they're legit. And then once they're legit, and only once they're legit, you can send them the final 70% payment. And so you can actually ship those goods out to Amazon to get started actually selling on Amazon. But one of the things that I was scared about when I first started was, it's very scary sending a 30% down payment all the way to China, you know, to a supplier that you don't really know that well. What if they just ran off with your money? And so what I teach my students and how I do it myself is, you can pay that 30% down payment using PayPal goods and services, which allows you to, you know, dispute that payment if there ever is any discrepancies. And a second line of defense is, you can actually pay on PayPal using a credit card. So just in case in some crazy situation, you know, your supplier ran off, you disputed it on PayPal and PayPal said no, you could still then dispute it on your credit card. And I've 100% of the time, in every case that I've had to do that, have gotten my money back via my credit card. So that's a really good way to keep yourself safe and to feel comfortable so you can sleep at night when you're actually starting out on Amazon and, you know, dealing with your first supplier, because it can be scary, and I totally get that. And then step number four, guys, is getting your units actually from your manufacturer in China or the USA or wherever you end up actually getting things made, all the way to the Amazon FBA fulfillment center, right? And the way that you do that is with what's called a freight forwarder. So there's generally two choices that I really like to recommend for freight forwarders. There's a company called Freightos, which is spelled pretty much how it sounds. They're a large company. They generally have very good prices. And there's another company that we use inside of my private student group called SellerKai, K-A-I, which is another really nice company with very competitive actual quotes when it comes to shipping. So Freightos and SellerKai are the two freight forwarders that I personally recommend. They'll take care of everything for you because shipping is very complicated and you don't want to deal with it yourself. And these guys know how to get it for way cheaper than you or I could get it anyways. So let them do that so you can focus on the important things, which are growing your business. And so they are going to take care of everything, getting your products from the manufacturer to Amazon FBA so that you can actually get started creating your listings and getting ready to start selling on Amazon FBA so that you can start to earn the full-time income that you're interested in. And as always, guys, we are going to have our comment winner of the day. For every one of our videos, we choose one of your guys' amazing comments, and we want to feature you guys to give back a little bit. So if you want to get your comment featured on our next video, all you have to do is leave a comment down below and make sure you subscribe and turn on notification bells, because we always choose a comment winner from somebody who comments in the first 60 seconds. So you have to be part of the Bell Squad to actually be able to take advantage of that. And so our first question is from Carolyn McCallum, who says, what are passive income gigs for Canadians? Well, that's a great question, Carolyn. And the answer is Amazon FBA. Some of my most successful students actually come from Canada. A lot of Canadians actually sell on Amazon.com, which is Amazon, the Amazon seller marketplace for the USA. But Amazon actually does exist in Canada as well. It's Amazon.ca. And so you can sell on Amazon in Canada, but I generally recommend that people sell in the USA as it's a much, much larger market. And so if you guys enjoyed this video and you wanna learn more strategies about how you can start to make money online, check out this video right here where we teach you how you can make $300 or more per day simply by typing names. I know it sounds weird, I'll prove it to you. See you there. I just made $300, or I could make up to $300 literally by typing names into a computer. And that might sound too good to be true, but stick around for this video, because I'm gonna